Good afternoon. This is Lewis Gray here with Google Developers Live. I'm speaking with Jonathan Beri, developer advocate on Google+. We're here to talk about Google+ Hangout apps. Now, you're going to be speaking next week at Google I.O. 2012.
That's right.
Talking about these Hangout apps. And I recently saw you do a broadcast on YouTube previewing this session. So I wanted you to have an opportunity to kind of give us an intro to Google+ Hangout apps, what you guys are looking at, and really tell us the state of that platform today.
Great. Yeah, so thanks, Lewis. Thanks for having me. Hangout apps have been in public availability for about 3 months. When we launched Google+, we launched with Hangouts, and the first thing we saw is people using Hangouts in creative and interesting ways that we never foresaw. And so immediately our first reaction was, we need to build a platform for the platform. So we launched Google Developer Preview for the Hangouts apps, and ever since then, developers in the community have been building. And out the gate, we launched several interesting apps with partners. And I'll be talking more about what we've been doing with Hangout Apps, the platform, and giving some demos at Google I.O. And last week, or a few weeks ago, we did a recording about the 101 level, the introductory stuff to getting started with Hangout Apps. And it's actually really easy to get started. This is sort of the takeaway of all that whole thing. We have developers around the world who are just jumping on and building really fun and interesting apps using that technology.
Now, I've gone ahead. I've been a user of Hangouts since they first came out, and it's been fun to watch those apps roll in from playing cards to drawing silly little faces, and I know that we're going to move beyond that. And so what we did, I know we had a lot of questions come in from people around the web. We put them in through Moderator as well as on Google+. I wanted to kind of go through those questions that have come through and have a conversation. So one of the questions that came in from Scotland, they were talking about the opportunity for applications to send anonymous users to a Hangout. You know, if an application authorizes a user with a third-party service like Twitter, for example, and wants to send them to a Hangout without them needing to register, is this possible? Perhaps we could have different options whether they're able to create or join.
That's an interesting question. So in terms of what we foresee, we really don't comment or speculate on rumors when it comes to features. But that's a great piece of feedback. Google Plus itself is about identity and being who you are and sharing who you are on the web. So in the foreseeable future, I think we're going to keep with that model where to take advantage of the Google Plus experience, you really need a Google Plus account. Now, there's nothing to stop you from having an application with your own third-party identity system and redirecting people to Hangouts and have them log in. There's also a login flow if they're not logged in already, but that's really core to the Google experience to take advantage of everything.
And what do you think about options coming up possibly in the future about customizing the entry to an application? You know, one of the developers was saying what he wants to do is present the user with a button, and once authorized, they can be sent directly to a configured Hangout. For example, not having the invite landing and configuration screen.
So we have some of that already today. It's called the Hangout button, and it's basically an image and a URL that you can put on your site. You can put it anywhere on the web that will launch a Hangout app. And you can do two things with that button. You can launch a brand new Hangout and just have it be a new Hangout. So if you just want to have users communicate, or you can pass in a Hangout to pre-populate. You can also pass in metadata with that Hangout. So if you're on a sports teams page, you can say, I'm on the blah football team, and it'll actually load the app with that configuration information.
Mm-hmm. Now, one of the questions that came in, you know, Google has a lot of different services and apps and APIs that we've rolled out, and so often people want to know how they interact with one another. So we know Google Plus is new. Hangouts are a little bit even newer than that, especially with the API being rolled out. People want to know, how is that going to integrate with things like Google Web Toolkit? This is something a lot of developers out there are using and are excited about. How do you see these two kind of technologies either complementing each other or working together?
That's a great question. If you watched the video that I recorded the other week, Hangout apps are just JavaScript, HTML, CSS, the power of the web, and tools you like to use. So if you built an application using the Google Web Toolkit, there's nothing stopping you from rendering that application inside of a Hangout as a Hangout app. And in fact, there's a developer in Japan, Aki Miyazaki, who built a wrapper for the Hangouts API using Google Web Toolkit. So definitely check that out if you're interested.
Now, I'm a big Android guy, and you can tell. You know, I've got the shirt on. I've got the Android figurines. I've been using Android probably since 2.1. I would have gotten there earlier if I could. But a lot of people have questions around the different versions of Android and what that does to impact the type of apps that we're building. So one of the questions was around the Google Plus Hangout API. How can it be used with Android? And is there any kind of difference between, say, Ice Cream Sandwich, which is the latest version, or pre-Ice Cream Sandwich devices?
So the first and foremost, Hangout apps don't run on mobile. So they're currently limited to the browser-based Hangout experience. And we've heard from a lot of developers, they would love to build the similar types of web-based applications inside of the mobile app. And that's just not on our roadmap right now. We're definitely exploring different possibilities around that. But then the differences between the different Android versions become moot.
Mm-hmm. That's definitely something we look at. You talk about developing for mobile, developing for the browser. I know we have a lot of focus to make sure we have a great Google Plus experience on mobile. We see that improving every day. And I can see, even with Hangouts, it's becoming even easier to join or start Hangouts as that goes. So I know a lot of people are really hoping to see that change and find ways to get Hangout APIs and Hangout apps working on
That'd
that screen. One of the things I take a look at is when you're in a Hangout, you have all these different options for different apps. Are there ones that come to mind that you say people are really gravitating toward? How are you finding the type of face-to-face experience that's available in a Hangout really making an application that much stronger?
So first, I'd like to touch about what makes Hangouts really interesting and fun and why we're seeing such a spike in usage. It's a piece of technology that helps you do something really meaningful and gets out of the way. You know, once you're in the video chat, you no longer realize you're chatting on a laptop with a camera, but you're communicating with a friend or a stranger or somebody who's really interesting. And then Hangout apps, the ones that really excel, are those ones that are not experienced in and of themselves, but makes the experience of connecting even stronger. So our favorite app, and the one we actually developed at Google, is the Effects app. It started with a simple mustache for Movember and November, but now we've expanded to crazy things like birthday hats and NASA helmets and snorkels. And so that's the type of application that it is not in and of itself a destination, but it's part of the experience.
Right. And one person was asking about native client. You know, native client obviously is a place where people are looking for development, especially when it hits the web. And Chrome's been talking a lot about it. When is that planned to be released for Hangouts?
Similar to the Android response, I would say, right now the Hangouts rely on the Google Talk plugin, which most Google users already are taking advantage of. So it just updates seamlessly. When it comes to porting that over to a native client, that'd be very interesting. And we think there's definitely room to explore there. But right now the plugin does work. And you know, as that native client matures, we'll revisit that.
What is it about Hangouts and Hangout apps specifically that make you excited as a developer yourself and excited to speak to developers about what they can do with Hangouts? What is it specifically, as opposed to looking at other places to spend their time and put their code?
That's a great question. Personally, I'm a web developer. I love JavaScript, I love HTML, I love CSS, and I like building web apps, especially games and interactive utilities. The best part of Hangouts to me and what developers love about it is it's just the web. And it's an iframe, it's your code that you can host from anywhere. You can put it on our server, so we take advantage of you can take advantage of our hosting. But you can use all the tools that you're really comfortable with. So that's the programming languages for the back-end development, like Qt, like Ruby, like App Engine, all the back the databases you like to use, and the IDEs you love to build. So now you can build apps that are really easy and really leverage the power of the web. But the extra cherry on the cake is the power of real time. The video, audio component, and the APIs that we provide make for a rich, synchronous experience that you can't find anywhere else on the web.
Now, talk about finding things anywhere else. You know, when I look at Google, one of the things that's really cool about this place is we have a lot of users, mm-hmm. and they're all over the world. And when you look at supporting all these different users with different geographies and different languages, there are things that come up like localization. And so there are some questions that came up around whether you can localize the terms of service, the privacy policy, support information. How much thought do we give when creating Hangout APIs, or even just the core Google Plus, if you could speak to that, in terms of serving markets outside of the standard North America and Europe?
That's a great question. It's actually very timely. This morning, we launched the ability to localize the title, description, and icon for your Hangout apps. And I'm pretty sure this question relates to that. And that's actually a pretty good piece of feedback. Right now, most people surface the terms of service, privacy policy, and the support page within the application itself. So you have control over that. And we'll certainly look at how we can introduce the same level of localization support for those built into the package. Hangouts themselves run in as many countries as the Google Plus can, so that we can legally run it. And so that means if you're in Sao Paulo in Austria, you can have a high-quality Hangout together, right? And just as well as if we're in San Francisco and Mountain View. And that, to me, is Google Scale, an amazing technology that's free for users.
So if we could leave with one thing, what is something that aspiring developers should know about Google Plus that you think most of them don't know?
There's a lot of stuff to talk about Google Plus, but I would say that there's a really strong community around Google Plus. And that means for developers talking to other developers. You know, we're having our Google I/O conference just next week, and 6,000 developers from around the world coming together, learning about new technologies, but also communicating with each other, socializing, networking. And I find that there's a strong developer community within Google Plus where I get to learn about new libraries, new technologies, new tools to help me be a better developer. So definitely check out this growing community within Google Plus.
All right. Well, I appreciate you taking the time, Jonathan. It really sounds like Hangout Apps are taking off. Yeah. We're just at the beginning, and I'm looking forward to what's next. And thanks for doing our Q&A.
Thank you, Lewis.
See you at Google I/O.
See you at Google.